seen a blind man cross the road, trying to make the other side. Ever seen a young girl growing old, trying to make herself a bride? So what becomes of you, my love?
What a lyric. The handbags and the grab rags that your granddad had to sweat so you could buy. Oh, it's always got me that. It chokes me up. Rod Stewart version of handbags and grab rags that was used to great effect in the popular sitcom The Office, which is 19 years old today. Well, it went out 19 years ago on the 9th of July, 9:30, BBC Two. The rest is history. It's a big day in this household. 19 years of The Office, not constantly. There's been breaks. Everyone's just not watched The Office for 19 years. Ollie, my little cat Ollie, who died earlier this year, would have been 17. Happy birthday, Ollie. And Jane's got a book out today. So that's the plug over with. Look, Jane Fallon, Queen Bee. Hilarious. So, order that online, comes the next day, read it. I think I've pretty much summed up what you need to do there. So, but Office and Ollie, and I've got to show you this, right? This was an artist did this after Ollie died, called Dana McFadden, I think. It really is a work of art. It's made out of felt, and I just don't know if it would do it justice showing you this. But can you see that? I mean, that's stunning, isn't it? That's incredible. And it could only be Ollie. I don't know. Look at a little fang. Oh my God. Every time I walk past that, it just sort of catches. Little Ollie. Incredible. Beautiful. And The Office is 19 years old. I just want to show you. This is like a show and tell. We've seen a book. We've seen a model cat. And this is the my only souvenir from The Office, apart from the cash. So that's all I got at the end. People, and I'll just take that, which is the bell from reception. And I did ask some questions to, this is like a special one, because I thought it's sort of three things I should do a little. And listen, hey, I miss you guys. So, I asked some questions. I think that most of them are relevant, but Dan just says, have you ever been to Spain? If so, how was it? We admire you here. Well, I have, Dan. I've been many times. Been to Madrid, Seville, Barcelona a couple of times. In fact, I did Madrid and Barcelona. I did Madrid just before Christmas and Barcelona in February before the lockdown. And it was just the beginning of the nice weather. It was like end of February and it was like 16, 17 degrees. And we walked to the beach and all the cafes were putting the tables out. Yeah, beautiful. Absolutely love Barcelona. And I had tapas. I'm converted to tapas. I just thought, what's the point? Little bits. I loved it. Have it with a drink, little bit. Oh, you want some more? Why not? Have a little bit more. Yes, I love Spain, and I particularly love Barcelona. Ollie Comic Strip says, how did you first realise the office would change your professional life? I don't know. It was such a big change anyway, doing it, suddenly being a TV writer with, quite a success. It wasn't immediate, but I knew it was my full-time job, and I suppose winning the BAFTAs, then I thought, all right, okay, this is working, okay? Yeah, I remember the night I won the two BAFTAs for the show and comedy performer. I was sitting back at home in our flat with the two BAFTAs, drinking with a little tuxedo. And I said to Jane, why didn't I do this before? And she went, you wouldn't have been any good at it, which is true. So yeah, I was 40 then. Gamma Thief. Goodness, like a sort of weird superhero, Gamma Thief. What was the first, maybe it is, and I just don't know. I'm so uncool. People go, yeah, yes, Grandad, it is a superhero. It's from DC Comics. That's all I know. Marvel and DC, that's the main two, isn't it? That's all I know. I don't read that nonsense. No offense. Gamma Thief says, what was the first TV show you watched and enjoyed? Oh my God. I don't know. I'd have been very little. I suppose cartoons, I remember. I remember my favourite thing when I first went to school was Tom and Jerry. I used to try and draw it, and I used to do stories. I used to write stories for Tom and Jerry. Oh, I think if I kept them now. Oh God, think of that. Think of my little stories in my book, Tom and Jerry, original stories for Tom and Jerry. Yeah, I remember Tom and Jerry and Popeye, because I remember my dad liked Popeye and he'd come in from work. Then I remember stuff that was meant to be for me that I didn't, those things that were, you know, like 5 to 6, things like Magic Roundabout. I thought, what the fuck is this? I mean, who wrote that? So yeah, I quite like the Wombles. I think I was older then. I think I was already a bit too old for it then. Clangers again. I remember being really little watching things like Watch With Mother, like Wooden Tops and Andy Pandy. Fucking weird as well. What the fuck's Andy Pandy? Andy Pandy? A lot of them were weird, weren't they? They were just weird. What was going on? Play School I liked when I was little. Toys. Humpty. Big fan of Humpty. Hamble. What was that? There was Teddy. There was two Teddies, wasn't there? Big Ted and Little Ted. What else was there? What was the other one? There was five, I'm sure there was. Hamble was just a doll. I'm sure there was another one. But yeah, Humpty got had a lot of time for. Didn't care for fucking Hamble. When I said this is a special broadcast, I meant worse than usual. I should have made that. Mary, Mungo and Midge. Again, I was too old for Mary, Mungo and Midge. I think I used to watch that when I came from school. Because I used to come home from school when I went to big school, when I was about 11. My mum got a part-time job as a dinner lady. So I thought, I can't do that. I can't be in the canteen with my mum. So I used to come home from school and she used to leave like hot dogs on for me and I'd watch a bit of telly. So I was thinking I was too old for that. Mary Monroe Midge and Rainbow. Again, Postman Pat. Again, too old, but I know Bagpuss, yeah. Yeah, I wasn't a big fan of that. Not enough happened. I think I liked Hector's House, I remember. Again, yeah, I liked Hector. Kiki and Zaza. Again, not a big fan. Oh, I'll tell you what I liked. Again, just I was mesmerised by it. Bill and Ben. The Flower Pot Men and Little Weed. Little Weed. Just weird stuff. Just weird stuff going on. Someone said I hated Hamble. Jemima, thank you. Yes. Pipkins I liked. Again, because that was mental. I liked Hartley. And Pig. Top Off the Monkey. Pig's Always Hungry. I liked that. Again, I was too old, but I think I might have liked it ironically. I just liked how mad it was. And Hartley was a bit, he was sort of angry and jealous, wasn't he? It wasn't like a kid's show. Yeah, okay. That's enough of that, isn't it? Fuck me. Hold on. Roy says, will you develop Kath and Sandy's characters in season 3 of Afterlife? That's exactly what you do. You get the main ensemble and know more about, with all the peripheral things happening, you invest in the characters that people have seen around but don't know much about. That's exactly what you do, and the payback's great, because the more you know the characters, the more you care about them, and so the stories can be richer, funnier, go further. So yes, the answer's yes. Interesting question that, though. That shows that a bit of insight, and they're not the characters you'd instantly, they're not the broad characters, they're the sort of staple, the office lot are the staple characters that people don't even know they want more of, usually, until you give them it, you know, because other ones steal the scenes, the crazy characters steal the scenes. But yeah, that's exactly what you do. Joey, the cat. Hello, Joey. If you could be friends in real life with one character from any of your shows, who would you choose? Derek is the first one that springs to mind. But any of the characters, be friends in real life with one character. I think it'd be funniest to be friends with. I think Derek I'd want to be friends with. Be funny. I like dim. Like Maggie would be funny. I like dim people. Dougie from Derek. I like dim people, you know what I mean? You like friends who say stupid things for your own amusement. I think Derek would be, yeah, be a good friend, wouldn't he? Right. Fiona. Or Auntie. Brandy, the dog. Can I choose a dog? Or Iva from Derek. I'm changing my mind now. They're not people anymore. Fiona says, have you ever thrown a kettle over a pub? No, I haven't, but I did hear someone genuinely brag about that when I was at school. It's the guy who I based Gareth on, who I went to school with when we were 14. It was just like Gareth. He was in the TAs, and he's the one that I talk about in my stand-up sometimes. He's the one who said, if you get captured by cannibals, they show you when you're a lot in the pot and they're cooking you. It happened. They show you pornographic pictures, so you get an erection and there's more meat. Wouldn't happen. And he's the one that said, I once told him as a joke, when a crab's drunk, they walk forwards. Right, clearly a joke. And apparently, when he was on holiday, he put a crab in some beer to test it, and he came back and said, "You're talking shit, Gervais." So I thought, well, that's why Gareth is like an adolescent, because it's based on an adolescent. And this bloke's mate, I'm not saying the names, this bloke's mate, who I based Gareth on, his mate was Kev. I based Kev. Think of that. So I went to school with basically a 14-year-old Gareth and a 14-year-old Kev. And they would swap stories. Like, yeah. So, a little bit of office trivia there. Right, one more question here. Oh no, is this Joey? Have I got them mixed up? I think this might be Joey's question. Oh no, it isn't. I've done Joey's question. This is in honor of Ollie. My question isn't really a question. Just a shout out to my fur angel, Susie Hope. Would be a truly special thing. So hello to your fur angel. And mention any charity. Yes, good. So let's keep it doggy. What about All Dogs Matter? Do a great job at a local charity. And the Mayhew, they do therapy training, and they do a therapause thing where they take dogs around elderly people or vulnerable people or people with issues, and they're brilliant. So yeah, a shout out to All Dogs Matter and the Mayhew Centre. Well, there you go. Shall I ask some questions on here? Oh, that's going too fast. Thanks for doing this, Ricky. My pleasure. All dogs matter. Yeah. Afterlife is brilliant. Thank you. Yes, the Mayhew. Old people question mark. I don't know what that means. Was that why the dogs, they go around old people's homes, and some of the people that might have dementia or something, they just cuddle a little dog. It's mutual. Dog gets a little cuddle. They're cuddling somewhat. So, you do the math. Hitchmo, yes. That's based on someone I work with as well. They used to talk like that, yeah. They used to talk like that. Exactly like that, man, yeah. Got a good name for him. Not his real name, obviously, but I call him Eric Hitchmo. And the act that he did really talk like that. So, yeah. I don't agree with that in the workplace. And he used to say that. That's where I got it from. He'd say, "Yeah, I don't agree with that in the workplace." Oh so there you go. What have we done? Office. Happy birthday, Office. 19. Thanks for watching all these years. Thanks for watching Afterlife and all my shows. And my stand-up. I'd say here's to another 19, But there's no fucking way I'll be around in 19 years. So I say, here's to another nine. Here's to another nine. Donate to, if you can afford anything, even a few quid to any doggy charity, any charity or cat charity, any animal charity, any charity. Makes you feel good, doesn't it? Buy Jane's book, there's a plug. And thank you once again for this, one of the most beautiful things I have ever seen. Only the real thing is more beautiful. Well, thank you. So back to normal. We'll do the usual one Sunday. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Stay away from people. Don't get ill. Work hard. Have fun. Have a drink. Tatty bye, everyone. Tatty bye.